Hello. I like to make today cupcakes and decorate them. In part one, we decorate as the princesses, and part two for the lovers of fairies. And what we do is we're using today a very simple recipe: soda pop cupcakes. And what we have is we have a 12-hole standard muffin tray, which is we line with a pink color. Cupcake liners. They come in, usually you can find them easily in multicolored packets. And what we've done also spray them after with cooking spray, canola oil spray or butter spray, doesn't matter whatever you're using, because this makes easier to remove after paper cases. So what we do is next we mix our cake mixture. For cake mixture, we're using vanilla cake mix. As you can see, it's 340 gram packet, which is quite small, really. And we just emptied contents of it. And as you can see, this is our dry cake mixture. So what we do is we add 1 cup, which is 250 mils of soda pop, but I using actually creaming soda, so is it okay? And it comes, as you can see, in a beautiful pink color. So we add all that together, and with wooden spoon we just started mixing until we incorporate all ingredients and our mixture become very, very smooth. This beautiful smell as well. Once it's all nicely combined, don't need any kind of special equipment, very, very quick. And here we are, that's our mixture already done. Now we subdivided among 12 basically cupcakes. Once you subdivided among basically our muffin tray, among our 12 pan holes, what we do is we place in a preheated oven to 180 degrees Celsius, which is 350 Fahrenheit. And we bake for about 15 minutes or until it's puffy and cooks through. Just to place a skewer in the center of a cupcake, once it's come out clean, our cupcakes are ready. What we do is then, once they cook through, just take them out, remove them to wire rack and cool completely before we start decorating. Now our soda pop cupcakes are baked, and as you can see, they have this beautiful shape, and they will come out in nicely raised and very, very light in appearance, as well as inside it's pink, which is beautiful as well. So in they now cool down, and in this part, which is part one, we will decorate them as princesses. So first of all, what we want to do is we want to basically choose our cupcake, and we have just a plain vanilla frosting. Of course, you can use any butter frosting or any other frosting of your choice. I using just a plain vanilla frosting, large with fitted with a larger fluted type of nozzle. And what we do is we don't need really much. We just created just a swirl, that's enough, and set aside. So that's done. And what we do is next we create our crowns. For the crowns, best of all, to make sure they keep this beautiful shape, to do them overnight. So use one of those leftover from your clean wrap or food wrap. See, as you can see, it's quite hard. And what you do is place a piece of non-stick paper on top. As you can see, I done it right here. It's a piece of non-stick paper, just a small piece, on top of this left, oops, on top of this leftover roll, basically, and on top of this leftover roll, place non-stick baking paper, and what we do is we create our crowns. You can use any of you can use also white fondant, pink fondant, yellow fondant, or any other fondant of your choice. If you're using say pink fondant, which is I color tinted last night with a deep pink gel food coloring, simply now if you need a little bit to make sure to prevent sticking while you're rolling on your working surface, just a sprinkle with powdered icing sugar, just a little bit, or use a silicone mat if you have one. So what we do, we just roll it to about thickness of about half a centimeter, and not too thin, about half a centimeter, inches and everything I will write in the description box. And I just briefly have a look. It's about 1/4 inch, basically. And what we do is, then we trim it, just to make nice rounded, basically, line. And then what we do is, you can easily use one of toothpicks and just draw what you want to see, sort of crown. You can make your own design as well if you wanted to do so, or simply use one of nozzles, for example, to cut out shapes of our crown. As you can see, we're using larger part to cut out larger parts, and a smaller, or probably we can use this one as well, actually. And it's just a simple plain nozzle I use it. It's about 1.5 centimeter in diameter, but it doesn't matter. You can use anything, even one of those containers, just to make sure they clean. So as you can see, now our crown is done, and what we have to do is we just shape it a little bit better as basically you want it. See, my hands is all pink. As you can see, this is our crown. So what we do is next to make it more special and more attractive, we use this pink edible rainbow dust, which is comes like that. It can be purchased from supermarket. If you have a golden crown, using golden edible dust, basically. And I use actually simple water, but you can use sugar syrup or sugar glue. No need much, just a tiny bit. I use for most of stuff actual water. Just look at, do I actually apply something? So we a little bit, just to brush it over, just to make sure it's enough to stick for us our pink dust. And what we do is, we sprinkle on top of our crown. Very, very easy, and it's very, very beautiful as well once it's set. They look so really great. So once we're done that, I just carefully place it on my hand. And as you can see, this is crown, which is very, very simple to make, and it's very beautiful as well. As I said before, you can use any small circular or nozzles or various tips or tiny glasses or any kind of bicycle objects which has round appearance, and just cut out these circles. So what's next is you have to simply just make sure you're able to see. Yes, you are. So if you have a, say for example, this one is covered, no, I'm just using this one, with non-stick baking paper, what you do is place like this, in this position, overnight, place on non-stick baking paper like that, non-stick baking paper on top of your roll as well, and let it set. Once it's set, it will come out just like that. As you can see, it's this one particular golden, and we just simply place our crowns on top, and we can have a look on them. Here we place them. Now, as you can see, we have golden crowns and pink crowns. Of course, you can use a lot of other colors as well. For example, silver or white, and you can use silver rainbow sprinkles on top of a silverish sort of crown. And on white, you can use a white rainbow as dust. See, it comes in a kind of like this sort of rainbow dust. This one pink, and this is a golden rainbow dust. You can purchase many different colors as well, just to choose which one you prefer. And as you can see, it's very, very simple to create this beautiful type of crowns. Also, if you like, while you're making crowns, you can attach one of those pastel edible confettis, and they come in different colors, and just attach them with the sugar syrup, sugar glue, or a little bit of water on top of crowns. Of course, if it's yellow, attach yellow ones will be on tops as well. If you like to do also a little bit more interesting decorations, and what you do is process is same. First of all, roll out fondant, cut it into simple shape, as I said before, using one of those plain nozzles or any simple clean round basically you cookie cutters or any kind little tiny glasses you can use to cut out this basically design of our crown. So once you've done that, if you want to attach this confetti on top, attach it, and then what you do is brush with the water or sugar syrup tiny bit and sprinkle with the rainbow dust, and here we are. It's a beautiful crown. It definitely will please little girls. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Everything will be in the description box. Until next time, goodbye.